Chapter 1 Lesson 2 Working with Files. In this lesson, we will cover the following: creating a new document, saving your documents, introduction to the documents folder, opening your saved documents, renaming your files, deleting your files, introduction to recycle bin, and restoring or permanent deleting the files. Hello everyone, and welcome back to our Windows 7 Basic to Advanced Video Training Tutorial. As if you are going through our previous videos, you may now have basic knowledge of working with applications. Today, we will create our first document using the simple text editing software called the Notepad. Later, we will learn some basic commands about managing files. The Notepad is a simple text editing software with basic formatting options, and is included in Windows 7 by default. To open Notepad, you will go through the following steps. Click Start menu, then click All Programs, Accessories, and then click on Notepad. As described earlier, if the application is not in full screen mode, you can click the Maximize button to stretch it to full screen. Now, when the Notepad opens, the top bar is called. The title bar, which is describing the program name, along with a temporary file name, called Untitled. The second bar with some options like File, Edit, Format, View, and Help is called the menu bar. Before we get to know more about Notepad commands, let's first type some text in our first document. As now, the first important step is to save the document. To save your document, you will click on the File menu, and then click on Save command. For the first time, when you will save your document, a dialog box will appear, asking you to type a new name, to save your current document, and the location where you would like to save your document in your computer. It is important to remember that while working with a new document, you must type a unique and meaningful file name to save it. It will be easier for you to recall the file in future if your file has a sensible name. And of course, you must remember that where you have saved your document. So, I am typing a new name for my untitled document and saving it to the default location, that is the Documents folder. After that, I will click on the Save button to finalize the saving of my data. Now, we have saved our document. Let's check it out where our file actually exists in our computer. As I have saved my file in the default Documents folder, you can find the Documents folder by clicking on the Start menu. Clicking on it will open the Documents folder, and will show you all the files inside it. So, we have our first document to work with. Let's check out some more commands to work with files. If you want to open your saved document, you can just double-click on the icon of the file. Then the file will automatically open the program associated with. You may have noticed that when I double-click on my file, Windows automatically opens the Notepad along with the file, as it already knows which program is associated with that particular file. If you made any kind of changes in your document, then it is important to save it again by using the procedure mentioned earlier. Our next command is how we can change the name of our document. For instance, while saving the document, I didn't bother to give a meaningful name, or I made a spelling mistake in the file name. How I can change it again? This command is called rename. To rename your file, right-click on the file you wish to rename, and click on the Rename command from the menu. Window will then point you to type a new name. Just type a new name or correct your spellings, and press Enter to finalize the name. We have covered creating a new document, saving the document, opening a saved document, and renaming the document. Let's see how to delete a document. To delete a document, first you need to move to the location where you have saved your document. In our case, it is the Documents folder. Click on Start menu, and then click on Documents. Right-click on the file you wish to delete, and click on the Delete command. Windows will ask you for confirmation if you want to move your file to the recycle bin. Whenever you delete a file using the method described earlier, Windows will always ask for the confirmation. This is because, if you have accidentally deleted a file, you may still have a chance to recover it from the recycle bin. Recycle bin is a storage place for your deleted files. If later, you decided to restore your deleted file, then you can recover it from the recycle bin, or if you decided to permanently delete your file, then you can also do it through the recycle bin. So, to confirm the deletion, we will click on Yes, and our file will move from the Documents menu to Recycle Bin. To recheck command, now we will open the recycle bin. Double-click on the recycle bin available on your desktop. You may see that your deleted file is still available in the recycle bin. If you have accidentally deleted the file, then you can restore it by right-clicking on the file and choosing Restore, or if you want to permanent delete the file, you can click on the Delete. If you click on Delete, then Windows will again ask you for the confirmation, as a warning message, that your file will get permanently deleted. So, choice is yours, if you want to permanent delete your file, or, do you want to restore it? As an example, we will restore our file back to the Documents folder. Right-click on the file, and choose Restore. Now, open the Documents folder, and we have our file back. That is it for now. My name is Rajiv Kohli and will come with more videos shortly, and do subscribe to our channel.